New coronavirus cases are being reported in India as the world scrambles to contain an outbreak that the World Health Organization has declared a global emergency. So far, there are no vaccines or medicines to treat COVID-19, the disease caused by the novel coronavirus. Only supportive care is what we have right now. But there are a number of steps you can take to protect yourself and those around you. The World Health Organization says the most effective protective measures are cleaning your hands regularly, properly covering your mouth when you cough or sneeze, and social distancing. If you're under the weather, even with mild symptoms such as headache and a slight runny nose, then stay home till you get better. If you have fever, cough and breathing difficulties, go see a doctor. Inform him or her about your travel history. Tell the doctor if you've come into contact with other travelers who may be at risk. One last thing to keep in mind, don't fall prey to fake news. There's plenty of misinformation out there on the coronavirus outbreak, and sharing it is dangerous. Follow trusted sources of information. These include the World Health Organization and the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. On this edition of The Big Picture, we will take a closer look at COVID-19 and how to be safe from it. Joining me on the program today are Dr. S.K. Singh, Director, National Center for Disease Control, Dr. Puneet Mishra, Professor, Community Medicine, AIIMS, and Dr. Shivani Deswal, Ram Manohar Lohia Hospital. Thank you to all my guests for joining me on this edition of The Big Picture. Dr. Singh, I'd like to begin the program with you. Let's first try and understand, because there's not much information that we have about this novel coronavirus. How much do we know about it?
Truly speaking, this is a novel virus, as you have already elaborated. But this one has been first genome sequenced in China on 7th of January. Prior to that, we were only receiving news that so many cases have occurred in China. And so this is causing a lot of mortality and morbidity. But now, when it has been sequenced, now it's known that it resembles genetically with SARS virus, but it's not exactly the SARS virus. There is some genetic difference between the two. But yes, it's a family of coronavirus, six of which have already jumped from animals to humans, and they are now causing disease among humans. Two have caused the outbreak, SARS in 2003, and thereafter MERS-CoV in 2012, which is still continuing in Middle East countries. So there is no correlation directly as such, but yes, it's a novel virus.
And what is the best way to ensure that we stay safe from it, Dr. Singh?
Safe, we have to understand the epidemiology of the disease. Number one is the incubation period. Number two, because it's a novel virus, we can only get through the travelers or through contact with the travelers who have traveled to the affected countries. So that's how the virus enters the country. We are tracking the travelers at the airports. And thereafter, in the incubation period, if they cross the airports without any symptoms, then they are being tracked in the community by the IDSP surveillance network. So that is the two mechanisms. Thereafter, if the cases are detected, as we are noticing now, so those cases and their contacts are further traced for a period of 14 days. We are advising public to remain in houses, remain in home isolation for 14 days, and thereafter the self-monitoring for another 14 days to cover the extended incubation period, which is of the disease, up to 21 days it is.
Okay. So, Professor Mishra, let's talk about a couple of aspects. One, of course, there seems to be a lot of panic as far as the general populace is concerned. Everyone seems to be getting and then receiving and sending those WhatsApp messages or social media messages. Is there a need to panic at that level, first and foremost? And what needs to be done? For instance, the WHO talks about washing hands and so on and so forth. Will all of this help?
Very good question you have asked. There is more panic than the real scenario. And if you see, I mean, what's happening every day in the news, what you see that there is no sanitizer in the market, no hand wash available, masks, they are not available, right? So, of course, this panic, but I don't think there's any need for the panic. This is a viral disease. Now we know, as Dr. Singh has said, that we know the complete genome of the disease. This is the coronavirus, the new coronavirus, of course. But this causes a lot of cases, they are asymptomatic. And those who are symptomatic, currently we are getting those cases who are exposed to the cases either through the foreign travel or through some other source. So we have only 43 confirmed cases in the country. Out of those 43, 16 are the tourists from the Italy. So the first question is, there is no need for the panic. There's a lot of panic in the public, and probably because of the media and social media. I think there's a need right now where the public should be given the correct information and the correct measures how to protect it. I think in the beginning you have covered all the messages which are required for the public. Number one, if they are having the symptoms, they should self-isolate. And here requires the discipline. If you ask me the one simple thing, that is the self-discipline. If you are having any symptom of cough, cold, fever, and the travel history, self-isolate yourself inside the house, consult the doctor, don't spread the disease. And if someone is having the symptom, they should wear the mask or should keep a cloth on the mouth when they are coughing or sneezing. That is what required at the moment. You see, there are a lot of people who are going with the mask. I don't think everybody requires a mask. If you are having symptoms, you might require it, but otherwise keep the distance. And the medical professional, they require a different kind of mask who are dealing with these cases in ICU or those dealing directly, they require different kind of mask, but they are not for the public. These masks are called N95 mask. So that is, I think, required at the moment.
Okay.
And the government is giving the messages through, you know, different media, phone, tune, and all those things that if you are a cough, sneeze, please cover your mouth and self-isolate. I think that is the most important message I can give at the moment. And don't touch your face and the thing frequently. And if you come across any of these things, just wash your hand.
Okay.
With any soap and water. That is required.
Hand sanitizers if you don't have soap and water?
If you don't have soap and water in those scenarios, you can use the sanitizer, but it's not that the panic kind of thing that sanitizer is not available, mask is not available. I have seen the news where it is being sold maybe 6 or 7 times or maybe 10 times.
Absolutely.
About the price, and the sanitizer is just lying. That is not the only thing. If you come across, just wash your hand. That is equally effective. It's not that only sanitizer, they are going to help you.
You know, Dr. Singh, there's so little or so much information out there. So it becomes difficult for a person to pick and choose, really. So water and soap over hand sanitizer, or is it both the same? What is it really?
I think I'd like to clarify here.
Yes, please.
There is no such dearth that you go only for the hand sanitizer or alcohol-based hand sanitizer. There's no need exactly. This is, of course, the better one, but the soap and water are equally effective. As he has already told, even if you wash with soap and water, only thing is that you wash. Whenever you enter the office, please go to the washroom and wash your hands. When you go to the house, our old Indian custom asks us that go to the washroom first, wash your feet, wash your hands, and take off your clothes and wear the home clothes. So if you follow these simple etiquettes, that's good. Second one, I think I would like to little bit more elaborate on the mask. For the general public, we have to clearly make them understand, if you buy one mask, it is not sufficient. You have to change mask after 6 hours or as soon as it gets soiled. So how many masks generally public is going to buy? And there is exactly no need. Once you, as you have said, he has also elaborated very nicely, once the person is having any symptom of cough, cold, fever or anything, or and have a travel history, please do wear mask. Don't use public transport in that particular circumstances. Go by your own car or ask the hospital. They will send the ambulance across to you and then you can go to the hospital. So these two things, because everybody is after masks, so they are raising the prices, black marketing is happening and a lot of panic is there. Once healthy persons are seen as mask in metro or in otherwise, general public gets scared that maybe he's having so many cases of COVID are moving the society. So that unnecessarily creates the scare, and that is why the panic.
Okay, all right, Dr. Shivani, let's take the discussion forward with you now. So the hospital that you belong to, RML Hospital, is one of the screening centers. You know, please tell us what happens at these screening centers. What is the SOP that is followed?
First of all, as sir said, there's nothing to panic and everybody does not need screening. So only if you have a history of travel and you are having symptoms of fever, cough, sneezing or difficulty breathing, that is the time you're supposed to approach a health facility. RML Hospital, gate number 5, the emergency gate, is the entry gate where you enter. As sir said, if you are traveling in a metro and coming to show at RML, you are exposing at least 100 people on the way. So if you have a history of travel and you have symptoms and you feel that you need to consult, you could probably call your doctor nearby and discuss with him if they're just flu symptoms. But if you feel there is difficulty breathing or, you know, your symptoms are not improving, you need to go to the health facility, then please cover your face with a mask, travel in your own car, or call the helpline number, and then you reach the hospital. In the hospital, do not enter the emergency or the main building because that is not marked for corona patients. And the trauma center on the back side, there is room number 1 and 2, which is marked for screening of these patients. Doctors are sitting 24/7. They are screening if you have a history of fever, cough, with a positive history of travel in last 14 days or contact with a person who's had a coronavirus infection. Then they take you as a suspected case and they take your samples. We have almost 10 beds which are isolated for corona patients. And if you require admission, the doctors would keep you under observation. And as of now, most important thing is supportive care. There is no medication, so it's supportive care. And being a pediatrician, I want to tell that as of now, there is no child which has been reported, so mothers don't need to panic. And the mortality worldwide has been almost minimal, 0.5%, less than 20 years. So I guess children have their own immunity. They catch flu every season in this weather, and they would behave exactly the same. It's only if a child is immunocompromised or an adult above 60 years who has diabetes or immunocompromised because of any other disease. They are at risk and probably they need to be more conscious at
sure.
the moment.
Sure. Okay. All right. Taking the discussion forward now, Dr. Mishra, is there a message that you would like to convey through Rajya Sabha TV to the general public of the country who are very concerned about COVID-19?
Okay. Definitely, I would like to give certain messages as everybody has else said about it. The first thing is, don't be panic. It's a viral disease. It's a new virus. It's spreading in the places. So how to protect yourself? Avoid the crowded places. Avoid unnecessary travel through affected countries. And if you are having any symptom of, you know, cough, cold and this thing, and you know, you think you have come across a person who has visited these countries or you have a visit to those countries, just go to the nearest hospital, call the ambulance, they will take you to the hospital and everything will be taken care of. The other thing is, as Dr. Singh has said, that when you are entering the office or coming back from the office, it is always good, wash your hand, change your clothes so you do not spread it. And the other thing is, don't give ear to the news which is fake news. There are a lot of people, they are saying, okay, taking alcohol, it's good. Others are saying drinking hot water, it is good. No.
Or some other medicines. Someone is talking about some homeopathic medicines and so on and so forth.
Since I am not homeopathic expert, I cannot comment on the homeopathic medicines. But in the modern medicine, as madam has already said, that there is no treatment. We give the supportive care. And, you know, more than 40% people, they are asymptomatic. So there are a lot of people who are asymptomatic. It's not that if you have the corona, you are going to die. I mean, most of the cases, they are going to be, you know, good after some few days.
And there are many strains of corona as well.
This is a different strain.
Yes.
The novel corona. That's why we said COVID-19. I mean, there are other corona and they had outbreak earlier as well. So there's nothing to worry. The mortality is around 1-2%. And it is more in the cases where you are above 65 years of age or you are having some disease like kidney disease or diabetes, or you are more prone for that. So don't panic. Use the, safety, this thing, precautions. Like if you are having cough and cold, please self-isolate yourself in the house and from the doctor. I think personal government cannot do anything unless you are personally disciplined. So I think if you ask me the one message, there should be personal discipline in the interest of the country. If you have cough, you have cold, you have fever, you have history of travel, or you have history of coming in contact with any such person, then please isolate yourself in the home, wear a mask, inform the nearest health facility, and do what they say.
Home quarantine and being responsible citizens, I think, is the need of the hour.
Okay. All right. So, taking the discussion forward now, Dr. Singh, so you did mention about how, thankfully, there has been no case of community spread of COVID-19 as such.
Yes.
So are we prepared for such kind of a situation? Could it happen, first and foremost, as far as this virus is concerned? Secondly, what is being done to ensure that we contain what we already have as much as possible?
So there are three parts to this question. Number one, we require community awareness and community supporting government measures. Unless and until the public is aware, public come forward with the cases, whosoever has got a travel history, he should report to the government. Government is taking many measures. I think you yourself are aware, right from Ministry of External Affairs to Ministry of Defense, for this quarantine of the persons which we brought from Wuhan. Still, we are having persons from Iran. So government is taking n number of steps. Not only health ministry, but textile ministry, Ministry of Tourism, Ministry of External Affairs. Everybody is coming together, including Ministry of Home Affairs. So they are coming together. They are there to help the public. Now it is the duty of the public to come forward. We have ample of opportunity, isolation facilities, quarantine facilities available. But yes, there is a possibility, definitely, because it's a respiratory virus. It's a heavy virus. It does not spread much through the this contact. But aerosol and airborne air droplets are the ones. Either they spread from person to person, 1 meter or less than 1 meter, then it will definitely spread. Second is, it settles down on the hard surface where it remains for 8 to 10 hours.
8 to 10 hours,
yes.
Lifespan.
In soft surfaces, it remains up to 2 days even. Even the sofa and all these linens, soiled linens and all, it can survive up to 2 days. So that is why we say that you have to be vigilant. You have to wash your hands frequently. If somebody has sat here and I now sit here, I use my hands here, and immediately everyone touches his face involuntarily at least 90 times in 24 hours. So that is a study. So it may be less, it may be no. But we have to change this habit right now. If at all we are comfortable with that, immediately I go and wash my hands, then I think the things are done. But I think Tootsi mist should be busted here. Number one, we are thinking that it will go with the temperature rise. It may not be exactly that, because Singapore, which is having a higher temperature,
Bahrain,
are having cases. So, but yes, activity is reduced. Once you have reduced moisture, high temperature, then definitely activity of the virus or the spread of virus is reduced. But whether it will go, nobody knows.
Okay, all right. So let's try to talk about a couple of aspects here, Dr. Shivani. One, of course, is the symptoms itself. You know, so is it so that you have to have all these symptoms at the same time if you have to see a doctor, or is it one of those symptoms, for instance, cough, runny nose, you know, sneezing, fever, body ache, there's muscle ache, I guess. There's so many symptoms that are attached to it. So when does a person decide to go to see a doctor?
See, it's difficult to say when does he decide, but we must understand that coronavirus is new. The symptomatology is still evolving. What we know at the moment is that patients can be afebrile as well, and cough and respiratory symptoms are worrisome. The dyspnea or the difficulty breathing or worsening of symptoms is occurring at the end of first week in most of the cases. So, and the second presentation could be GI, could be diarrhea and vomitings. And third could be myalgias, like a normal flu that we get. So every flu, we do not go to the doctor. Only if, again, if you have a history of travel, if you have a history of contact, you must inform your health authority, and again, use mask at home so that you don't infect your close contacts, because the transmission is high among the close contacts, and you stay at home. But if you're having difficulty in breathing, if you feel that your symptoms are not subsiding and they're worsening, I think it's time to go and visit your doctor.
So definitely, let's talk about the flu now, a common flu. What are the symptoms of a common flu, and how long does it take for a common flu to go away? Now, say for instance, there are many people who are going to the hospital with a common flu thinking that it could be coronavirus.
Yes.
So, if you could elaborate on that.
In this winter season, probably influenza and RSV, which have not been talked about, are more common. Patients are suffering more from RSV and influenza. And it is, again, common flu, viral infection, we always relate more with respiratory symptoms. So it is a high-grade fever, having body aches, myalgias, and it starts with a running nose, then you have a cough. And in very few percentage of cases, especially when you're immunocompromised or you're diabetic, it progresses to a pneumonia or a ARDS, which is the last stage and behaves like septic shock. But this is, we must understand, a very, very, very less percentage of. So it's like a normal flu. It's very difficult to differentiate at the moment the symptoms that we have. There are theories that probably dry cough is more common in coronavirus compared to the swine flu or the influenza.
But these are just theories.
Yes. So I think the best is the travel history and the contact history that you suspect corona versus any other flu.
Okay. All right. Time to get closing comments now from all my guests, starting first with you, Professor Mishra. You know, here in India, we have this tendency of taking pills all the time. You know, you have a headache, you take a pill. You have a fever, you take a pill. You have a cold, you take two pills. You know, so what do you do in situations like this? I mean, do you self-medicate? Because self-medication is a big thing here.
Yes.
So how do we deal with that?
No, I strictly say it is not required. Self-medication is not required for corona. The other thing is there's no treatment available for the corona. If you have fever, and for fever, if you want to take something, only paracetamol you can take without any prescription. Otherwise, the best thing in this season is if you suspect it, you have travel history or you have history to come in contact with a person who is known or suspected case of corona because of travel, then please inform the health authorities. I will say don't even travel by the bus or metro. Inform the health authorities. There is a number which is given, circulated by the Government of India. 24-hour helpline is there. Ambulance will come to your home. They'll pick you up. They'll take you to the exact facility where you are required. And if you require further care for admission or anything, they will take care of it. So don't do any self-medication. If you have fever, it's high, you can take only paracetamol, no other analgesic or antipyretic.
All right. And Dr. Singh, so what's the best way forward as far as this is concerned? And also, like you mentioned, it's not like we know too much about it, so there's not really a time frame that we are looking at as well. So, I mean, what's the best way forward?
No, my one more advice I would like to give. Everybody who comes in contact or has a travel history immediately rushes to the hospital for getting sample tested. Because it gives a false sense of well-being. I test my sample on the very first day. I come in contact with a positive case. My sample gets negative, and I feel that I'm okay. It's not like that. Any time between the 2 to 14 days after having contact or after having met an infected person, you may get the disease. So you have to go for the sample testing whenever you get symptoms. Please don't flog the hospitals without having symptoms. Isolate yourself in the house. If you get symptoms, wear a mask, call an ambulance, or go by any transport, a private transport, and go to the hospital. That is one. Regarding the other thing which you said, that how the picture evolving, yes, we are ourselves learning with this. We are getting data daily, both from the international sources and national sources as well. And we are ourselves getting prepared. Logistics are in place, hospitals are in place, quarantine places are in place, and everybody is prepared. And I think eternal vigilance is the price of liberty. So
this 2 to 14 days, Dr. Yeah. Singh, I just wanted to get some clarity on that. Since we're talking about this, let's get everything out there, you know. So as far, why 2 to 14 days? If someone is infected, does he get cured in 14 days?
No, not like that. Once a virus enters a person of a healthy person's body, it takes time to multiply. And when it multiplies to a certain level where it can cause symptoms, that is the time when first symptom appears and the virus enters. So that time period is called the incubation period. That varies in person to person, depending on the immunity of a person, depending on the age of the person, depending on the vulnerability or the virus load. So out of these three, when the combination, it can be in 2 days. If a person is immunocompromised, if a person is higher age or low immunity, or the virus load is more. Many times they are super carriers are also there, super spreaders, which we call in this particular, which we saw in Korea.
Right.
South Korea. One person spread in the church, spread to maybe thousands of people. Same in the Diamond Princess, this cruise ship.
Cruise ship.
So that is how the disease spreads. Once it is spread like that, then it becomes difficult to control.
And do we have any information about how long it will take to cure a person once he's infected?
It's not exactly. It's a viral illness. It settles down. I said that my previous two colleagues have already elaborated. When 80% of people, the illness is mild.
Right.
In 16 to 14%, it goes into the severe stage. Then 3 to 4% only goes into critical phase. Yes, definitely, a lot of things are not known. But yes, and so ages, if you are above 60 years of age, above 70, it goes up to 14% mortality. So we have to be careful. But healthy person, it is between 2 and 3%. So that is not a cause to be worried about. But older persons, definitely we should be careful and we should be taking due care of them.
Absolutely. And Dr. Shivani, close the show for us with your concluding remarks.
Don't panic. Practice self-discipline. Home quarantine in mild symptoms, but report to your health authorities, your history of travel. Be responsible citizens. And hand washing, etiquettes, namaste that we all are prescribing. Keep a safe distance from an infected patient or a patient with any flu symptoms. And avoid unnecessarily travel and crowded places.
Okay, all right. I think we've covered pretty much it all. Thank you to my guests for joining me on the program, putting things into perspective and sharing your views on the big picture. That's it from me. See you again.